Merry, merry, happy, happy. How are you? Zenobia here, tech diva and the luxury lifestyle. I was just telling Chris, it's so quiet in here compared to last week with the Dama Tequila Agape Expo and lots of friends and supporters, and just, it was just a great party. So you can go to the YouTube channel and see it if you missed it, and see it again if you were here. Okay, we're going to still do our Christmas music theme. I decided the playlist was so cool and there was so much stuff going on. I'm just playing the music over again this week. But I have some things to talk to you about as we end 2014 and begin, can you believe, 2015? Here we go. See you in a bit. Hi there, I'm back, Zenobia. Well, this is, can you believe it, December 31st, in some places still on the planet, in other places it has already transitioned to January 1st. So anyway, this is an easy day for me today. Not a lot of stuff going on today. I'm going to mostly play music, but I do have a couple of things to give you a heads up on. No What's That today, but I got a bunch of them that are stacked up for the new year, and I'll be going to a new format to do that. Based on some feedback that I got from some listeners, some watchers, and some listeners. So the show, this is the pilot season. We've tried out a lot of new things. And I have to give Chris a big shout out and a thank you because I sent him into all kinds of stuff last week at the party because I said, oh, I want to do the show over there. And he made it happen. On the fly, that's Tech Diva, and who I get to be surrounded by to make my guerrilla style, let's just try stuff out technology-wise, get it done. Okay, so you just heard the first Noel, and that's George Howard, who we lost a few years ago. Well, many years ago now, a long time ago. He was on a vacation, I think, in Thailand, and there was a mishap there. But we still have his music. I carry his music on my phone. Okay. Oh, it's rattling. Okay. I have these headphones on because I'm listening to some stuff, and for change, I'm blinging here, and it's interfering with the microphone is picking up anyway, so I have to lose the headphones. I got some props today because that's what I'm going to talk about. You see me with stuff around my neck. Okay, and then prior to that, we Free Kings, and that was Rahsaan Roland Kirk Quartet. And as I mentioned last time, Rahsaan Roland Kirk is from the era of the 60s and the 70s progressive jazz, and he was an artist who played a lot of instruments all at one time. It was just amazing, amazing to watch. And so I was really kind of thrilled to find this piece, We Free Kings, from Have Yourself a Jazzy Little Christmas. And opening the show was Chick Corea and the Electric Band, God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen, and that was from Contemporary Jazz Christmas. Yeah, there's not a lot of jazz Christmas music out there, so I have a lot of tunes that I've gotten from Contemporary Jazz Christmas. And so there's a couple of CDs out there. So if you're searching around, that's one of them that you can look for that has a lot of variety of jazz artists, hardcore jazz, not. There's some smooth jazz in there, but it's along the lines of the artist that I like to listen to and that I like to play. Okay, Zenobia here, Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle. I just want to say real quickly, this has been a labor of love to do this show and to pull it off, and it's a dream of mine. I actually did do Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle online show a couple of years back on another network, and I will give props to that network for giving me the opportunity to get back into broadcasting, which I'd done in college, way back in college days. And so my life has kind of come in a circle, and I've circled back to actually doing broadcast again, which is kind of fun, and I still like it. So this ends up being a good thing because it wouldn't have lasted this long if I didn't like it. But I love this because it's like my laboratory to try technology things out, but at the same time, it's a classroom on TV as well as on radio, because I will be pulling this off into podcasts. So watch, this is a work in progress, and I'm trying all kinds of new things because the technology exists to do it, and it's very touchable. That's why I'm the touchable tech diva, because I'm making technology touchable and doable. And I'm like the case study. The show is like the case study for trying out different kinds of media technologies. And I'm a geek like that. I love doing this kind of stuff. But at the same time, I love passing it on and seeing you in the audience being able to use some of this in your business or in your lifestyle. Thus, Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle. because we're doing technology to make our lives more efficient so we can have time to have a luxurious lifestyle the way we want and to live our passion. So I'm giving you some tools and to put in your toolkit to be able to actually do some fun stuff and do some passionate living stuff. Okay, I'm going to play some more music now and stop chattering, but you're here, Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle. I'm Zenobia, the touchable tech diva. And why? Because I make technology touchable so you don't fear it, but you embrace it into your lifestyle so you can do your passion. Okay, see you in a bit. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello. Okay, did those sound familiar to you? A lot of these do sound familiar, but I got some new ones coming up, some original tunes coming up later in the playlist. Okay, Ramsey Lewis, love him since I was a little thing. I remember when I was in about eighth grade, I was, so this is a little personal note, but a thing about Ramsey Lewis. Eighth grade, I'm head cheerleader, and I have to choreograph our cheers for our volleyball team. And at that time, I'm In With the In Crowd by Ramsey Lewis was like the hit. It actually crossed over into what we call into the pop world. It wasn't called that back then, but that's what that was. And I choreographed our cheers with the pom-poms and all of that to the In Crowd. And that was a lot of fun. So a bit of history taking me back. Okay, so that was Ramsey Lewis. He's still a fabulous player today, and he's working. Okay, that was from The Sound of Christmas, and you know what that was. That was Merry Christmas, Baby. And then prior to that, a dear friend of mine, Jacques Lejeune, did Not Another Fruitcake. That's the name of that tune. And that's from A Crenshaw Christmas. And yes, he's an L.A. local. And opening up the set was Joe Sample, another one of my favorites. And that was I Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus. And that was from Making Spirits Bright, A Smooth Jazz Christmas. Okay, so I got all this stuff here today, chords and stuff. It's just chords. And the reason why I'm showing these is because this is a long way around. Next week, the first week in January every year, is the Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas. And the whole world now has probably seen some news clip about the Consumer Electronics Show showing some absolutely wild stuff that's out there that manufacturers want you to maybe buy. Anyway, I've gone to this convention for a long, long time. It focuses on consumer products. Those are products that they're going to want to sell to you. Then later on in the year, I go to Vegas, same place, to the National Association of Broadcast Convention, which is another large convention, but that focuses on professionals and tools, gear for professionals. So I get both. So I do the consumer and then I do the pro. So this Consumer Electronics Show, if you don't know, it's been around for decades, and it's probably one of the two top, if not the top, and largest consumer gathering of manufacturers and retailers in the world. There may be one in that's held in Asia that might be as big, if not bigger. Anyway, it's the time to go. For me, why I still go, people say, why do you go to all these conventions, all that stuff? Because it's my chance to see, especially for this show, what the manufacturers are testing out in the marketplace and what it is that you're going to be forced to buy later on in the year. I shouldn't say forced to buy, but the new products that come out. Because you know the cycle for product longevity is very short. It's lucky if it's a year now, and it's really good if it lasts a couple of 3 years. And those are the products that I like to find. Not because they're classics and they cross over with their features or with their technology, so you get some longevity out of it. Anyway, I trekked to Las Vegas, and I have to tell people, no, I'm not going to gamble. Las Vegas loses money on me because I don't gamble. I'm lucky if I spend $10 on a slot machine. I'm there pounding concrete at the convention center for 8 hours a day. It's work. This is work to me, but I enjoy it. And I'm a geek, so I love seeing all this technology stuff. And it fills up the whole convention center, several hotels, because for instance, the high-end Audio is in a hotel all of its own that takes up about 6 floors. And hopefully I'll get a chance to go there this time. Usually I get caught up in all the computer and electronic stuff. I don't get to the high-end audio, but there's some stuff that's going on there. So I'm going to trek there, see what the major brands, the Sonys, the LGs, and then also the minor brands, because what happens at the Consumer Electronics Show is because you have all these vendors, the big box houses as well as the independents that go there to look at gear, a lot of times a new company, software, there's a lot of new little, you know, iPhone companies and companies creating accessories for mobile, as well as, you know, 8K displays that NHK shows. And they just get a booth, they'll spend the $30,000 or $100,000 or whatever it is to set up at the Consumer Electronics Show. And it's merely to see what the 100,000 people that flows through think about what their idea is, what their product is, and it's a proving ground to see if it's something viable to go to manufacturing and to go to production. So there's a certain area that a lot of companies, a lot of newbie countries, companies set up shop at, and you kind of, so I always go through there because it's always some little tiny company or some little product that's stashed in this whole big vast convention room that is really interesting and has something to really offer. So I always kind of cruise through there and I pick up the cars. A lot of them are looking for United States distribution. They don't have distribution here. They're seeking distribution so they can go on and do production. So it's really interesting to go there from year to year because most of them are not back a second year. Or they have graduated because they did get traction and they go to the big hall, the big convention center. So some of that happens. One of the big ones that happened last year was with 3D printing, and has 3D printing like going stone cold crazy? I mean, there's a 3D printer that was in a Staples. Okay, go figure. And that's going to be a topic that I'm going to cover, you know, about why this whole 3D printing thing is disruptive. Some of it is not in a good way, and but a lot of it can actually be in a really good way. And a very well-known celebrity named Will.i.am is very much into 3D printing and is an avid supporter. In fact, at the last CES, he was speaking at one of the booths about how he was so into 3D printing. So that's something that we'll be dealing with. What am I looking for when I go there? I'm looking to curate products, that is to hand pick and hand select products that I think are good value, that have some worth in terms of making our lives more efficient, making my life more efficient, because I have like several lives and I have to try and make the best use and be able to have stuff instantly around me when I need to jump from one life to the next. So I'm a life jumper and I gotta have tools that help me to do that. So that's why I do Meet Your Cell Phone workshops, to help people to make that a viable tool and not just about texting and making a phone call. So a couple of the things that I'm really looking for this year when I go, well, next year, next week when I go, is any product, viable products that will have traction to untether. And what do I mean by untethering? That means cutting the cord and having wireless power and wireless connections. Okay, so here are my props. All right, this is what I have to carry in my car just to make sure I can keep my phone going, keep my laptop going. And you've been in places where you needed to plug in okay? And you're looking around and like me, I'll look around in a restaurant if I'm just hanging out at a restaurant, I want to take my laptop and do some work. I'm looking on the walls for a plug so I can plug in my laptop or my phone, okay? So here we got all these different adapters. That's for the wall. This is for the car. And now the one thing that came out of CES is USB cables that now you can get a charger, a wall plug that you can just plug in the USB. So if you lose your cord, just find a $2 USB cord and you're going. So anyway, what are we doing? We're looking around for places to like plug in and to charge up. So I found some products this last CES that will allow me to untether. I'm going back to see if some of those companies are still there, if the technology has gained traction, one of which is called Qi Power. And it's a power that now a lot of the Android phones have it built in so that you can actually just put your phone on this plate and charge it. So that's a case of untethering. And then I'm looking for solar chargers and solar power, which I found last time too. And I'm going to go back and see how far that has come and be able to offer those products to you so you can cut the cord. That's a big saying now, is cut the cord. We need to get rid of all of this stuff. It's 2015 in a second. Let's get rid of all that stuff. So that's when I plan to come back with some little videos. I got my little iPhone. It's perfect for this, and I grab little pieces. I actually have a few pieces that are up on my YouTube page, so I'll be letting you know where that is, and actually I'm about to upload some more from last year so you can see some of the things that I've been looking at. Okay, and also the good thing about CES is I am like a fly on the wall because all the major box companies are there. They're making the deals, so they get better deals than we do because they're loading up a bunch of different stores. So I kind of keep my ear to the ground for what it is, or to the ground, for what it is that they look like they're going to push. And I look for other products so that I don't have to compete with their pricing, like the Costco's and the Best Buy's and all of those big box stores. So I find other products that have just as much, if not more value, because a lot of times those products aren't the best buy, but they got the best deal from the manufacturers, and they work out separate deals. This is behind the scenes on the retail side. And so I try to look for other products that aren't going to be all over Amazon, all over eBay, all over, you know, the big box houses. And but will do just as well function-wise, if not better, and also are good value, or something that sometimes some of these products you just have to spend the money because you're gonna get it back from the usage and the savings in the efficiency that you get from using those products. So, okay, so let's get rid of, we're about to get rid of these, okay? About to get rid of these. Okay, so CES next week. I think Chris and I are going to Skype me in next week from the show, and this ought to be really interesting. Another tech diva, let's try this out and let's try and do this. So stay tuned and tune in next week. And I'm kind of excited. My head's so, I'm trying to figure all of how to make all of that work and all of that. So it's going to be fun. I'm going to do this. We can do this because everything is there for us to do this. Okay, let's go back to some more music. And this is a set. This is my men entertaining you. And there's I'll Be Home for Christmas. There's two versions because I couldn't not do one of these two artists that are doing this. So enjoy. Zenobia here, the Touchable Tech Diva. This is Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle, Tech Tools, Toys, and News, Hot Jazz, Passionate Living. See you in a bit.
can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. Oh, I'll be home for Christmas if only.
Now hear what I say.
Well, okay, silence. On Silent Night, oops. Okay, most of you, a lot of you will recognize the Temptations. I had to throw that in because it wouldn't be a holiday season without the Temptations. Silent Night, and then you heard Will Downing, I'll Be Home for Christmas. And that was from Making Spirits Bright, A Smooth Jazz Christmas. That was one of those two CDs with holiday jazz. And, yep, we had to, like, jump in real quick because we could do that. Okay, so we will continue with the second I'll Be Home for Christmas. Okay, and this is Darius Rucker. Okay, see you in a bit.
Merry Christmas from the Temptations.
I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you, I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. I'll be home for
It's Christmas now. This is when we see all the angels dancing in the sky above. Just for us, it's Christmas Day. Something to believe in. I believe the love that we feel for each other is his gift to us. And nothing will keep us apart if we love with a Christmas heart. It's Christmas now. This is when the eyes of our children search into these eyes of ours. How sweet they are. What kind of world. This heart we'll share, so those who count upon us can know we love and know we care.
Thank you to my men. These are my men. I love these men. Okay. And actually, it's been very calming. I was just telling Chris, it's so quiet and kind of peaceful here after last week, running on adrenaline and all the stuff going on. Although that was really fun. I don't know how often I'll do that, but that was really fun. Even Chris said it was fun, so that's good. But now today it's kind of a peaceful, you know, transition to 2015. It was really cool. Okay, so who was that? That was Luther Vandross, of course, with A Christmas Heart. Love that. And prior to that, as I mentioned, was Darius Rucker and his version of I'll Be Home for Christmas. That's from Home for the Holidays. And actually, Luther Vandross, you can find that on the Classic Christmas album. And then we had The Temptations with Silent Night. And prior to that, again, Will Downing with his version of I'll Be Home for Christmas. Okay, so now we're going to get into the ladies entertaining us, okay? Enjoy. We'll do the little lady set. Zenobia here. Don't have a lot to say now. I'm done. Okay, so enjoy the music. See you in a bit.
When I'm worried and I can't sleep, I count my blessings instead of sheep, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. Getting small, I think of when I had none at all, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. I picture curly heads, and one by one I count them as they slumber in their beds. If you're worried and just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you fall asleep counting your blessings. Blessings instead of sheep, and you fall asleep counting your blessings.
There's a place that I know where the sycamores grow and daffodils have their fun, where the cares of the day seem to slowly fade away in the glow of the evening sun. Peace when the day is done. If I go there real late, let my mind meditate on everything to be done. If I search deep inside, let my conscience be my guide, then the answers are sure to come. Don't have to worry. Life's true meaning comes to you, and the freedom you seek is won. Peace is for everyone. Peace is for everyone. Peace is for a merry little Christmas.
Thank you, ladies. Very cool. Lots of original stuff right there. Yeah, for the holiday seasons, it's always so refreshing to hear the classics, but just some new music, new voices, new lyrics, and with style. Okay, so these are our women. Lettucey, and that was Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. Very innovative arrangement there. It's from It's Christmas. And prior to that, Nora Jones with a tune called Peace, P-E-A-C-E, Peace. And that's from A Very Special Acoustic Christmas. And opening up our ladies' set was Diana Krall. And that was Count Your Blessings Instead of Sheep. Love that. Christmas songs, and that was a bonus track version. So there you have it. Yes, I'm doing Christmas songs today. This is the last vestiges of this Christmas season, this holiday season, as we get ready for 2015. I'm still, just to even say that out loud is it's amazing. But hopefully you had a great 2014. Got through the trials and the tribulations. And so take a breath. We got about 30 more minutes of my show for you to chill out, take a breath. And let's get 2014 behind us and move forward into 2015. I'm excited. Yeah, with this whole doing the Skype in next week from Vegas is kind of a exciting kind of way to start the first week of the new year on Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle. I think that's going to be really cool. Okay, I'm stopping talking. Okay, but this next track is really cute. You need to stop and listen to the lyrics to this. It's actually a Miles Davis and a Gil Evans tune from way, way back, but it is so today that it makes me smile. Anyway, okay, and then after that, I have another one of my all-time favorite Christmas songs is coming up after that. And yeah, we got some more. We got a little bit more music that I didn't get to play last week. Okay, Zenobia here. Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle is where you are. Tech tools, toys, and news, hot jazz, passionate living. We're doing a lot of music today. See you in a bit.
I hope you have a white one, but for me, it's blue. Blue Christmas. That's the way you see it when you're feeling blue. Blue Xmas. When you're blue at Christmas time, you see right through all the waste, all the sham, all the haste, and plain old bad taste. Sidewalk Santa Clauses are much, much, much too thin. They're wearing fancy rented costumes, false beards, and big fat phony grins. And nearly everybody's standing around holding out their empty hand, our tin cup. Gimme, 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 gimme. Fill my stocking up, all the way up. It's a time when the greedy give a dime to the needy. Blue Christmas, all the paper tinsel in the fal-de-ral. Blue Xmas, people trading gifts that matter not at all. What I call fal-de-ral, bitter gall. Backyards, while you're very, very busy addressing 20 zillion Christmas cards. Now Yuletide is the season to receive and oh to give and ah to share. But all you December do-gooders rush around and rant and rave and loudly blare. Merry Christmas. I hope yours is a bright one, but for me it's
Yes, the last vestiges of Christmas music. I know people were getting so tired of Christmas music, but see, mine is so different. You don't hear these in the stores and overhead speakers. Anyway, okay, so that was Jeff Golub, and that was Here Comes Santa Claus, and that was from Making Spirits Bright, a Smooth Jazz Christmas, and prior to that was, this makes me so happy, I play this in my car, like, for miles. It's called Sleigh Ride, and it's Alexander O'Neill, and that's from My Gift to You. That that CD actually went out of print, but now I see that it's back in print, because you couldn't find this in iTunes or anywhere to buy it for a bunch of years. But it's so popular, I'm so glad that I got it when I did, that it's back out, and you can, I think you can get it again. And then opening of the set was Miles Davis and Gil Evans. Okay, so think about this. Miles Davis and Gil Evans, they go back to the 50s when they did, I think, Sketches of Spain. Way back, anyway, might not have been Sketches of Spain. That was Miles. But that was the era of Gil Evans and Miles Davis doing in the transition from bop to what we know as our modern jazz for us baby boomers. And anyway, I found this and I thought it was so cool. It's called Blue Xmas. And I do have to find out who the vocalist is, though, who did that. But the lyrics are just so today. So today. Okay, so I don't have a lot to report today, just kind of a chill out cruise into 2015. And I think I've got one more music set. Oh, I might have to even find another song, huh, Chris? I might. Anyway, that's very rare, because usually I have so much music left over for the next show that you always have something to play. So a couple of these songs didn't get played last week because it was so wild in here. Anyway, okay, I'm going to stop talking, play a little bit more music. We're actually going to test out the Skype to make sure that it works for next week. Okay, Zenobia here, the Touchable Tech Diva. This is Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle, and we're going to do some more tech here in a bit. Okay, enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you. section. Starting narrator. Tooltip, details. Jump left. Exit narrator dialogue. Focus on yes button. Alt plus Y.
Hello. Okay. So while you were listening to Oh Holy Night by Phil Sheeran from The First Noel, and The Christmas Song by Joyce Cooling from Making Spirits Bright, A Smooth Jazz Christmas, we were in here testing Skype. So we tested it on my MacBook Pro and we tested it on my iPhone. So I'm ready, and Chris is gonna push me to actually do a little segment on the convention floor, because now I know how to flip the cameras on my iPhone. So we're going to try that. This should be real fun. This is internet television, and I can do what I want when I want to do it. So that'll be fine. Okay, so Ashley, we're a few minutes early here. I want to say I hope that you had a productive 2014. We're coming into 2015. Happy New Year, and let's make it a really great and productive year. But also, we got to have some fun and do our passion throughout the year, because it's the right thing to do. And it will make us feel good and we can do more. So it's all in the mix there. So Zenobia here, the Touchable Tech Diva, bringing you Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle, tech tools, toys, news, hot jazz, passionate living. Happy New Year, and we're going out on jingle bells. It's kind of fun. Okay, God bless. Take care. Bye-bye.